Hello students, and welcome in today's session. Today we are going to learn chapter number 7, evolution. Now in this chapter we are going to learn about evolution process. First you tell me what is mean by evolution. Do you know? Yes, evolution is a process in which the living organisms develop into more complex and more adaptable forms in their environment. Yes, evolution is a process. As I said in my definition, evolution is a process. Will you tell me one more answer? Is evolution a process or a result of a process? Just take an example. We, human being, evolved from our ancestor, that is apes, right? So today's modern man is evolved from the ancestor. So this is the result of a process. So will you tell me evolution is a process or a result of process? Just think on it and give me the answer in comments. Now let's see about more evolution. As like us, different living organisms are there, that may be the plants, animals, birds, aquatic animals, microorganisms. These are all evolved. So what do you think? They all have the different ancestors, or all they evolved from the one ancestor only? If we go in past, that also we will see in this chapter. But whatever the biodiversity is there on the earth, that how it is evolved, and before evolving this biodiversity, what was there on the earth, how the earth is formed, and before that how this universe is formed, that we are learning in this today's topic, evolution. So let's see evolution. This evolution is nothing but creation of a biodiversity from a common ancestor. You can see here it is a stock indicating a common ancestor, and according to the different adaptations of the organisms, different types of organisms are evolved from the common ancestor. This is what the evolution in the organism. And before that I said, if we want to see the evolution of the earth, so for that, there is a theory giving the origin of the universe, and the name of that theory is a Big Bang theory. According to this theory, there was a small spot, a very small minute spot, which this minute spot just become brighter, and goes on expanding, and get burst, right? So this is what a Big Bang theory. It's not like that there is something kind of a bang, right? It is just bursting of a particle. And as the particle bursts, it expands, right? So in the figure also you can see that this is the particle. This particle just get expand, and due to the expansion, this is the area which is covered, right? So as the particle get expanded, here the area is increased, and whatever the temperature was there, that goes on decreasing. If you will see the here the series of the temperature, then it is of the 10 raised to 32 degree, then it decreased to 10 raised to 27 degree, like that 10 raised to 15, 10 raised to 18, 10 raised to 9, then it is 6000 degree, 18 degree, and here the 3 degree. As the temperature decreases, at that time also, here this time is also given. This is the timeline. So how much time it has taken to expand? As this particle has burst, you know that the bursting is very fast process. So here the bursting and expanding this much area, the first circle you can see, right? That it took only 10 raised to minus 43 seconds. Means it's very less time. as you go on ahead here. So here up to this much expansion is here, it occurs within a second. Here the time period is given 1 second, and here the temperature decreases from 10 raised to 32 degrees to 10 raised to 10 degrees. This much less temperature decrease, and still the still these particles goes on expanding. In 3 minutes, temperature reduced to 10 raised to 9 degrees. Now here from 10 raised to 9 degrees means on the 10 you have to give the 9 zeros. That much high temperature is there. Now here it is given suddenly sharp decrease into 6000 degrees. But here again the time period is also given. It is after 300,000 years. From this time, 3 minutes time, after 3000 years, the temperature was 6000 degrees. And that time you can see here some of these structures are formed. And it is looking like some of the planets, some of the galaxies. So, which the particle get expanded and burst. So, from that small particles, what is here distracted. Small particles are get spread. So, from that particles, again, these structures are formed. Some of the galaxies are formed. Again, we go ahead here. 1000 million years after this 1000 million year, the temperature is near about 18 degrees shown here, and there also again this process of formation of the galaxies is going on, right? And as we go ahead here, after 15,000 million year, here some of the structures like DNA is shown here. Human being means life was formed here. So this much long time has taken to form a life from this particle. So this is what the time period and the temperature change given according to the Big Bang theory. This particle get expanded and universe is formed. So in this universe, if we see, there is a small one galaxy there, and that one galaxy is there. In that, somewhere our solar system is there, and in that solar system our one planet is there, Earth. And on that whole Earth also, there is a somewhere small part of India is there, there we are living, right? So this universe is a very, very, very huge, and in that very small minute place is ours. So this is about the how universe is formed. Yes, now we will see some of the structures which is formed during the universe. So these are some of the stars like structures which is formed in the universe during this Big Bang theory. These are some of the galaxies, right? Here the particles expansion was given. So this is one more picture from which your Big Bang theory is clear. Now this is the picture which shows you the formation of the Earth. So among these forming all the planets and the galaxies, in that one of our planet Earth is there, that is forming. So these particles are there, that is get gathered, because due to expansion every particle is moving very speedly, even rotating also. You know that Earth is revolving and rotating. And because of that, these particles get gathered. And it was very, very, very hot. So because of that, this again get cools. So temperature is get cooled. And this very hot ball was there. That is becoming cooler and cooler. And finally, our Earth structure is formed. Now, when the Earth is formed, in the initial stage, what was the atmospheric condition present on the Earth? You can see here a hot ball-like structure of the Earth, right? So in that condition, what was the atmosphere? It was not like today what we are experiencing present atmosphere. That time, as this Earth is formed 4.5 billion years ago, right? And it was just very hot molten ball like structure. And as it is revolving and rotating, it slowly get cooled. And because of that cooling structure, its outermost structure is there that get little bit solidified, right? So this inside that earth, as outer cover is solid, inside it is little bit still liquid. And now also, today also, we are experiencing that the hot liquid which burst outside sometimes in the form of volcano. And when the earth is formed, that time also so many volcanoes are bursting and pumped these liquid outside on the earth. Then this liquid will flow, get cooled and becomes a solidified. In this way the surface of the earth is formed. That time dominant gases which are present on the earth, that is nothing but the water vapors, near about 60%. Then carbon dioxide gas was there, that is about 20%. Then sulfur, it was present in the form of gas only 10%. Along with this is about 90%, remaining 10% in that nitrogen, argon, helium, neon, CH4, carbon monoxide, hydrogen. These are some of the other gases. And if you compare these atmosphere with the modern atmosphere, then among that we have nitrogen 78%, oxygen 21%, and argon only 1%, carbon dioxide 0.03%, very less. But if you will check here, it is 20% carbon dioxide. So this is some of the information about the atmospheric condition present on the earth when the earth is formed, means 4.5 billion years ago. As this process of cooling of earth goes on doing, then in that you have seen majorly 60% water vapors were there. As this water vapors goes get cooled, then it will come down in the form of rain. Now this water, liquid water, again get vaporized due to hot earth and becomes water vapor. As the earth slowly cool down, the liquid water which comes on the ground get saturated in a big structures, right? So these structures where the water gets saturated afterwards become a ocean, right? So this is the how ocean is formed on the earth. Here the formation of the earth is over. Now on this earth, life was not there at all. As you have seen, very hot climate was there, 800 degree centigrade temperature was there. So in that, no life can occur on the earth. Now how the life is formed, how the life is originated on the earth? So our next point is origin of a life on the earth. So for that, so many theories are given by the different scientists, like theory of special creation is there, theory of spontaneous generation is there, theory of panspermia or cosmozoa, both are the same, it is there, and theory of chemosynthesis is there. So among that all, this is the theory of chemosynthesis or theory of chemical evolution which was accepted. Now we will see one by one theory. So let's take the first theory of special creation, right? So for this, so many stories are there according to the mythology. Take one example of Hindu mythology. So in a Hindu mythology, you know that God Brahma is there, right? So it is said that this whole world, this whole earth and all the organisms on the earth are created by the Brahma. As according to the Hindu mythology, there are three gods, three murtis are there, right? These are nothing but the Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. Brahma is the creator of this life. Then Vishnu is the caretaker and Shiva is there, that is destroyer. Now why there is need to destroy? Because once the life is formed, then it can't be remain as it is. When it will be destroyed, Then and then only once again a new life will be formed. So these three gods are there. They are just balancing this universe or the earth. This is what said in the Hindu mythology. So see here, according to the Hindu mythology, what is said? This world was created by God Brahma, and in that men and devils and gods are there, that is developed from the head of the Brahma. Then birds are there, that is developed from its chest. Goats are there, that is come from his mouth. And the plants are there, that is come from his body here. So these are some of the stories. One more story is here that whenever Brahma get vomited, that time all these different lives, forms of the lives came in the exist. And one more thing, according to this theory, whatever the lives we observe today on the earth, whenever they formed billions years ago, so from that time it is till today as it is. There is no any change in their structure or form. Means there is no any evolution takes place from any life or any organism from their formation till today. So scientist has discarded this theory. One more is there. According to the Bible, it is said that this whole universe is there. It is created by the God. And in that, God has created all these in different days. Like on the first day, he has created light and time. On the second day, he has created sky and separate it from the water. So in this way, water and sky is created on the second day. Third day is there where he has created plants, lands, and some of the water bodies like lake, well, river. So some of the water bodies, these are created on the third day. On the fourth day, he has created different planets and stars, right? Then on the fifth day, he has created the moon, sun, sky and fish. Then on the last day, sixth day, he has created land animals and the human. So this is how the God has worked for all 6 days. And you know that in 1 week there are 7 days. So God has continuously worked for all 6 days. So he get tired, and on 7th day he has taken a rest. And that's why we have a holiday on Sunday. Right? So this is what some of the stories or theories given by the mythology, how the life is originated on the earth. But this theory is also discarded. Next theory is that the theory is a panspermia theory. Now this theory means what? Panspermia theory. According to this theory, life is not originated on the earth, but it has come somewhere else, right? From the other planets it has come, maybe in the form of spore or seed or particle, but it has come from somewhere else planet. It has landed on the earth, and from that particle, from that spore, the all living organisms are formed on the earth, right? So this, whatever this particle has come, that particle is called as a cosmic body. So this whole living organisms are there, different living organisms are there. These are all formed from this cosmic body. So this is said. But this theory was also discarded by saying that any spore or any particle or any seed, whenever it has traveled in the space, then how it has survived? Because in the space there is so many ultraviolet rays are there. So there was no any proof how it has survived, remained alive in the space. So this theory was also discarded. Next theory is that the theory of spontaneous generation, or this theory is also known as the theory of abiogenesis, right? So biogenesis. A means absence, bio means life. A life, without life. The life which is formed, that is formed from the object which don't have life. Means living things are formed from non-living things. So what this theory says? This theory says that there are some of the organisms are formed from some non-living things. For example, here frogs developed from the falling drop of rain. Means whatever the rainfall is there, from that rainfall drop, the frogs are developed. So it is said that whenever the rainfall is there, so with that raindrop, small, small, small frogs will come on the land. So this is what the theory. Another example is that mice arose from sweaty underwear. So whatever the sweat is there, from that sweat, mice are formed. Another is that any decaying meat is there, so from that meat, flies are formed. So these are all non-living things, from these other living things are formed. Another example is that meat produce maggots, then mud produce fish, then grains produce mice. So these are some of the examples which says that the non-living things produce living things. The theory of spontaneous generation or abiogenesis is discarded by the scientist Louis Pasteur. Right. Now how he has discarded? He has proved that the life will be originate from the pre-existing life and not from the non-living things. He has done experiment for it. So for that he has taken a swan neck special flask. Right. So you can see here, this is a round bottom flask and it has having a curved neck like structure flask. Right. Swan neck flask. Right. So what is the speciality of this flask? Due to this structure, it will avoid the contamination in the flask. So air cannot pass through this neck and no contamination will occur in the flask, the material which is present in the flask. So for that, he has taken some of the froth, or you can say a meat, in the flask, right? He has boiled it and kept the flask by keeping that in water. Here in this area, he has filled water. So air will not pass through this neck, right? And whatever the meat was boiled over here, or froth was boiled over there, it was remained as it is. No bacteria was developed in that. And the second set was there. He has done the same. He has boiled the broth. After that boiling, he has just cut that neck, opened that flask and kept it open. And what he saw, the flask which was unopened, unbreak, there was no any bacteria's growth are there, or no any life is formed in that flask. But the flask which is open, break, in that he found some of the microorganisms or life is formed. So this provided that the non-living things cannot produce the living organism. If living organisms has to be formed, then some living organisms need to come over here, lay their eggs, and then the new living organisms will be formed. Means life will arose from pre-existing life, not from the non-livings. So in this way, Louis Pasteur has discarded the spontaneous generation or theory of abiogenesis. Now let's see the chemical evolution of life. The theory of chemical evolution. The life is evolved from the chemicals. See, in this, two scientists, that is Operon and Handley. Operon is from Russia and Handley from England. These two scientists proposed that life may have arose from non-living organic molecules, not non-living things, right? they said that some of the organic molecules will be there. These organic molecules comes together and first life has formed. So to prove this, there is a scientist, S.L. Miller, right? In 1953, he has done an experiment. So in that experiment, what he has done? He has created the early earth atmosphere in the lab. Now see here, this is what kind of his experiment arrangement. See, this is a flask, right? So in that, there are two sticks which is carrying the electric charge. These two sticks, they will discharge the electricity. And this will play a role of lightning which occurs that time on the earth. Along with this, this flask also contains the gases like ammonia, methane, hydrogen, water vapor at 800 degrees centigrade. Because that time also earth's temperature was very high, right? So this is the flask which approximately having the similar condition of the earlier earth, right? Now, whatever these gases are there, they get cooled. So this cooling is done by keeping here a condenser. Here, this is the inlet of cold water. This will go from here, the air which is coming from this, gases which are coming through this, get cooled. And this is the outlet of hot water. So in this way, these gases get cooled. So here, this is the, you can say, kind of a ocean which is present on the earth. So this is kind of water bodies where these gases will get condensed, come and mixed into this water broth, right? Now, for this, there is one more round bottom flask. Here, in this, boiling water is there. This boiling water get vaporized and water vapors will be passed in this flask, right? So to avoid the contamination and all other things, here the vacuum pump is there through which earlier whatever the air is there, that is get removed. And whatever these water vapors are there, they are coming here due to this lightning, and these are some of the gases are there. They get due to this electric discharge. You know that electric discharge is a kind of energy. So due to this electric discharge, these molecules may get separated, may get reunite with some other molecules, and some other new molecules are formed. So these all formed, interformed, newly formed molecules are there. They all comes and get gathered over here. So this is kind of a soup. So whenever they have tested this soup, so in that they found some of the molecules like amino acids, conservatives, or kind of proteins, polysaccharides, disaccharides, right? So this proves that the every living organism's basic structure, carbohydrate is there, or amino acids, you know that protein which is formed, that is formed from the amino acids. So these amino acids are formed or found in this broth. So this experiment overall, it is proved that the some of the organic molecules are formed in this broth due to these earlier environmental conditions which is present on the earth. And because of these proofs, we can be sure that life may comes or arose from the chemicals, right? Inorganic molecules or organic molecules. Even one more proof is there. Whatever the meteorites we got, which fallens from the space on the earth, when we analyze them, so in that meteorites also, we found the same types of molecules in that. So whatever the conditions we have seen here, process we have seen here, that may happen in the space somewhere, right? That's why this kind of molecules we found in meteor. So this theory of origin of life is there. Majorly it is accepted by many scientists. So this is what most accepted theory of origin of life. That is, life arose from a chemicals. That is, whatever the small organic molecules are there, they must have come together and formed first self-replicating unit, that may be the RNA or a DNA structure. And then maybe from that self-replicating structure, a prokaryotic cell must have formed. Then from that prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell have formed. So in this way, the first life on the earth has come from the inorganic or organic molecules. So this is how you can study this, how the life is originated on the earth. Very important point. Based on this, so many times question will be asked in the exam. This is what the most important point which we have studied. So diagram is important and explanation is again important. So prepare this chemical evolution of life very nicely. Other things that like 1 mark, 2 mark questions will be asked from the different theories which we have studied, like panspermia theory is there. What is mean by panspermia theory? Next is that abiogenesis theory is there. So who has given this abiogenesis theory, or who has supported abiogenesis theory? Aristotle and Paul, these are the two scientists, they have supported abiogenesis theory. Then another question is that who discarded the abiogenesis theory? So who has discarded? Louis Pasteur, by doing experiments and proved that life comes from pre-existing life, right? So these are some of the different theory based questions, 1 or 2 marks. And 3 marks question will be asked based on this chemical evolution of life. One more point is there, that is early environment of the earth. So what are the different gases we found on the earth in early environment? Based on that also 1 mark or 2 mark question will be asked. So these are some of the important points from this today's topic. So prepare this well. All the best.